Today is the Canadian premiere of Turbo Kids. Cinemaniac interviews Laurence Leboeuf, Michael Ironside, and Monroe Chambers in a post-apocalyptic Serie B movie. Let's start with the trailer.
I will destroy you with my Turbo Glove, the ultimate weapon against the robot threat. But to be a true hero, you'll have to save your girlfriend.
Hey, what's that in your hand?
It's a comic book.
What's it about?
It's about Turbo Rider.
That's rad.
I always wonder what the other side looked like.
It's kind of gray and dusty. Well, I could show you.
Around here, we like to do things with a little more joie de vivre.
Where is she? Release the girl!
This is gonna get ugly.
As you may know, the situation is critical. We have reached maximum casualty level.
Who exactly are you supposed to be?
Turbo Rider.
This is it, soldier. We have to hit these sand machines with everything we've got.
Find them, kill them, and lead back their heads on pikes.
I'm meeting up with an old mate. We're going straight to Zeus.
Ah.
What do you say?
Been more like the real Turbo Rider.
But you could totally be Turbo Kid.
Allo, Laurence.
Hello.
Alors, Laurence, it's a first in your career in B-movies, I think.
Yes, it is.
How did you feel about that gender first when you received the script?
Well, what I liked mostly was the eccentricity of it, I think. It was the fact that it wasn't taking itself seriously, that it was funny, that it was eccentric, that it was out of the box, and that it was kind of an homage to B-series films and 80s movies, and that at the same time we have this great love story between two characters that's very touching, and I think I like the explosion of all of our characters. And
that's a very important character, because that's the most humoristic, I would say.
Yeah.
So that's kind of put you somewhere maybe you haven't been.
Yes.
Like,
yes.
Trying to be, yes, a little bit out of what you already know.
Yeah,
not to be fond of you, but you know, make fond in the whole crew.
Yeah.
So how did you do the rehearsal, or how did you find your character?
Well, we found it, pretty much together. I mean, it was already written so well, you know. They wrote a script that was funny already, and it's hard to write humor, I find, and it must be hard to... The comedy beat was already there, you know, so we just had to explore and then improvise and stuff. But we had a rehearsal with Monroe and the three kids, and I think just reading it out loud and finding that energy and that finding Apple was just so funny for all of us, and that's where we knew that this is where we're going. We're going there that way, and this naiveness. And it's funny because she's so naive, because she's seeing the world with pink glasses, you know, and it's, everything is fascinating.
And you're still on a bike, same as last year for La Petite Reine.
Yeah, it's true. When I saw them and I read the bikes, and I was like, oh no, please, no more, give me a break. But it was fun, because it wasn't that much, but I think I'm getting pretty good on a bike.
Yeah, and last question, are you usually a fan of bloody movies like that?
Well, not the bloody as much as the fantasy that I'm a fan of.
Okay.
Like, I'm a big fan of Lord of the Rings and all these things, and so it's more like the fantasy kind of movies. The gore, no, but why not? Like,
yeah,
it doesn't bother me.
It was weird for the first time you've seen it, because you were acting, but it was the first with all that blood and stuff.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Yeah,
so
it's quite something. Yeah, yeah.
Entertaining, maybe?
Yeah, for sure. You watch the thing, you're like, oh my god, his head just exploded, and you're like... It's nice to see, and it's nice to see these guys work too.
Yeah, that's a great
The special
story.
Effects guys, like, and I mean, we don't have $150 million to make this movie, you know. So they have to be creative and inventive and find new ways to make it work with little money. So it's it's so nice to see what they come up with, and they did an amazing job. And it was really nice to see them work.
So tonight is the first in Canada.
Yes.
Are you looking forward to see how the public is going to react?
Yeah, very much, very much. I mean, I heard Fantasia was the perfect audience for it, and that they were expressive, and that it was going to be quite, there was going to be a lot of energy in the room, so I'm very excited to see that and be part of it.
I'm sure it would be perfect.
Hey, what's that in your hand?
It's a comic book.
What's it about?
It's about Turbo Rider.
That's rad.
Speaking about gender, but let's say Siri, maybe it's like the name of Turbo Kid is not the name, the gender.
The film is a satire. Turbo Kid is a satire on these kind of films. I was sold on the idea when I talked to the directors, as I think you were, that they're going to take this genre as far as they can, take it to an edge. Hopefully we don't go over it. You know, when you got body parts sticking on people's heads, it's over the top.
Yeah. And Monroe, you auditioned for the role, the main character.
Yeah.
What made you feel the willing to go inside Turbo Kid? Why did you want to do the character?
Well, first, it was their decision if I'm the right fit for it.
Yeah.
And at that point, I read the script, and I've never done a film like this ever.
Uh-huh.
And I never thought I would ever do something like this. It's so outlandish, so much blood, so much gore in that way. It's so crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I read it, I loved the storyline between Apple and the kid.
Yeah.
Because it's such a nice, cute, romantic story, and it's a really nice coming-of-age film, really, at the core of it. And when you throw all this kind of crazy stuff around it, I thought, this could be a lot of fun. And that's what my father said, because it's a big risk doing a film like this, because how do you make it big, but make it genuine?
Mm-hmm.
And so my dad's like, this film could be a lot of fun. Read it again and tell me how much fun you have. And I read it, I was like, this is going to be a blast. How can I not take this?
The thing we got to talk before the film was is taking the stereotypical characters and pushing them to the limits. When he's doing stuff where he goes, ta-da, and strikes a pose, it's not an actor's choice. It's more of a director, producer, story, everything to sort of, how far can we go to look like a comic book, to put tongue-in-cheek and make it funny? You know, my character going up and going, let them all die, or something like that.
Save the girl.
Save the girl. You know what I mean? How do you do that and make it real enough that it's convincing without passing comment on yourself, without winking at the camera? It was a lot of fun. It was difficult to do.
I'd like to do things with a little more joie de vivre.
Anouk-François Yohann, hello. So you are the co-director of the post-apocalyptic action comedy Turbo Kid. The first Canadian premiere is tonight. I know that the movie went to Sundance, which is a great satisfaction for you, I think.
Well, it's a dream come true, I believe. It's we couldn't have dreamt of a better place to have a premiere, and Sundance was surreal. It was fantastic. It's like, it was walking, we were walking on clouds for the whole time we were there. It was incredible.
Yeah, and the buzz starts from there, and then it continues, and not tonight, Fantasia, and then the movie goes out in August, I think, here.
Yeah, we'll be released on the 14th of August for Quebec and the 28th of August for the rest of North America. And I believe the world, but don't quote me on this.
Okay. Okay, so you wrote the whole script with thick sense, let's say.
Yeah.
So how is it difficult to write the three of you in the meantime?
Oh, we've been doing it for 10 years, so we have come with a way of working that is ours. We really sit, the three of us, around the same table and just pitch ideas and transform those ideas and just have fun with it and just start to write and argue. We do argue a lot. And
I would say it's the only place that we argue when we write, but it's for the good
of the strip. Yeah. And
talking about ideas, there's lots of ideas in the film.
Yeah, a lot of crazy ideas that, like, you throw at one idea and then somebody adds to it, somebody twists it, and when it gets to the script, it was so much debated that we are the two of us are sure that it's a great idea to leave it in the script. Mm-hmm. So, no, it's a great way, and it's a lot more fun to write the three of us together.
Yeah, and we don't go into voting, so it's really when the three of us agrees on an idea that it comes to word in the script.
Okay, so. You do like storyboards a lot, which is something that we don't do a lot nowadays in all the movies. Would it be possible for you, for fans, sorry, to have copies of it maybe one day?
Do would
you
love
consider
to.
Yeah. That?
That'd be a good idea, yeah.
Maybe with a DVD or something, I don't know when it could be, but some kind of special features, let's have the storyboard.
That's a brilliant idea, because I know that François drew a lot of the storyboard, but there's also another amazing artist called Jack Dion. Mm-hmm. He's a comic book artist from Montreal that did a lot of the storyboard, and that man is brilliant. His art is brilliant. I urge everybody that's listening to that interview to just find out who Jake Dion is. His work is incredible, and he's a good friend of ours, and he'll join us on our next projects as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That could be a very good...
would be a good way to see what we wanted to do and what we were able to
do. Yeah, also, yeah.
Mm. Because there was a lot... like, every day was we have to make sacrifices. Mm-hmm. So that's one thing we learned on that shoot, but... I think we really wanted to preserve the story, and what we cut was mostly action, BMX chases, or gore effects.
Okay.
But at the end, I think it was the best decision, because it's very the story that is important. It has to be a good story, mm-hmm. and the characters as well. So
yeah. Talking about the characters, I can say this is one of the best part, like with your main characters. I want to talk about Laurence Leboeuf, because we talked about with her, and she said that she agreed to be in Turbo Kid after seeing herself on a poster.
Yep.
Kind of the final poster.
Yeah.
What was the idea behind that?
It's kind of a inspiration pictures, yeah. And it's François, who's very talented in Photoshop, and he just like creates a montage of the actor's face with all the costume and everything.
Let's say we have
Laurence
Leboeuf, and then let's do that.
Well, I think it's a better way to approach an actor. Like, you do not give them just the script. You give them a picture, and you said like, you want to be in my movie, you'll look like that. So mm-hmm. I think.
And it's a good way also for the actor, when she's reading the script, to have a visual of her character while she's reading it. It's a great tool.
Yeah. The most important problem was the weather.
Yes.
Yes. With your part, like doing it, like it was very minus 10, I think, when you directed it, and it was supposed to be like 15 or 20.
Yes.
Yeah.
How did you handle that?
It was hard. Every day was hard, because equipment kept breaking. Props get breaking, blood would freeze in the pipes, because outside it was minus 10, but we were filming in a whole warehouse, and there was snow all around it, so inside it was like minus 15, and we would go inside a hole for the pool scene, and inside that pool, it was like minus 20, it was so damp, it was brutal, and all the costume was not made for that kind of weather, but nobody ever complained. Everybody came together, they believed in the project, and they fought for the project. That's why the whole crew, the actors, are a family now. Mm-hmm. Like, we owe them a lot.
And in the pool, Lawrence keeps on smiling.
Yes, so which is incredible.
Yes.
And it's a testament to her talent, and she brought the character of Apple to another level.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
Like, everywhere we've been, people has fallen in love with her.
Yeah. Thank you guys for that quick answer you had on the interview. And I hope the movie would find out. It is public, but I'm pretty sure it is. It would, sorry. So good luck to you.
Thank you so much.
Go see it in theaters.
Yeah, support independent films.